Our world is changing. The mass extinction we feared has already begun, and we are the cause. We are the infection. But like all living organisms, the Earth unleashed a fever to fight this infection. Its original and rightful rulers, the Titans. For thousands of years, these creatures have remained in hiding around the world. And unless all the Titans are found, our planet will perish, and so will we. They are the only guarantee that life will carry on.
What's good, y'all? So we just had the new Godzilla Monster trailer drop, as you just seen. So I wanted to talk to you a little bit about it and let you know how I felt about what they're trying to give to us next year. Well, from what I've seen, it looks like they're trying to do better than the first Godzilla movie, because that movie was crap. When you only got your main character, you know, monster in the movie for like 10 minutes, I think you all need to be fired. But far as this movie, I think they tried to make up for it by giving us a wide variety of monsters. I love when we get to see Mothra, the big-ass blue butterfly. That's my favorite character in the Godzilla universe, is Mothra. And look like they, I hope that's Mothra, but you know, besides from that, Godzilla looked like he got diabetes, overweight. I don't really like that. They need to get rid of some of that gut. We had a three-headed dragon. I mean, we had all types of monsters in here, so I'll give them an A+ for that, for going into this movie with the intention of, yeah, we fucked up the first time, but this time we're going to go overboard and give them a lot of monsters. Now, the only thing that you can do wrong with that is at the end of the movie, there better be an all-out 10 monster, 15, 20 monster battle royal like the WWE. It better be every monster that you have in this movie better be like doing some really cool shit, because if you have one die in a lame way, then it's a complete waste. I give up on your universe. All y'all need to be fired. It's a joke. We need to have these monsters destroying shit and destroying each other. Go over the top. Don't halfway do it. Now, as far as the human aspect of it, if you listen to my channel, I do not like human beings in my monsters and sci-fi movies sometimes. Just depends on the content. So far as this movie, I think they tried to walk a fine line. Just based on the first movie, how they just barely had Godzilla in the movie, I think that they're trying to balance it out way more in this movie. We had a couple of returning characters. Those doctors who were in the first movie, they came back. Why you kill off Bryan Cranston's character, I have no idea. That's a joke. That's complete BS to me. So that really took away from the first movie. But this one, it looked like they're trying to balance it out more with having human aspects mixed with the monsters. But see, here's my problem. You're going to have a human aspect of military, then you're going to have this family with Millie Bobby Brown's character. See, that's already two-thirds of your movie is being dedicated to the humans. So I already know going in that I'm going to get the backstory with Millie Bobby Brown, I'm going to get the military aspect, and then left over here for the last part is going to be the monsters. I don't know. See, I'm already getting the feeling that we're going to get little short some monsters here and there, but you guys are going to let us down as far as going all out over the top 30 man battle royal rumble with all the monsters fighting at the end and just killing each other. I don't know. I want to believe in this movie, but I guess just on past experiences with Hollywood producers and watching their films, and they don't know shit about what the average person want. I just think that they're gonna tease us with all these monsters, but they're not really gonna put the money into the CGI to give us a whole, you know, good chunk of the movie as far as the monsters being in it, because it's gonna cost too much. So they're gonna tease us. We probably got the best shots in the trailer. I mean, I don't know. I really don't have no faith in them. I gotta be honest with you. I just don't think they're gonna spend the money to have all these monsters fighting for an extended period of time in the movie, just because it'll cost too much. But I don't know. As far as I've just seen, this trailer was cool. It was perfectly fine. It made me look forward to seeing a movie, like, far as just based on this trailer without their history. I want to see this movie. This looks like a cool ass movie. It's like a good summer blockbuster or whatever you want to call it. Looks like a great movie. But based on their history, I think they're gonna fuck it up. I think we just seen the best parts of the movie just right now. But I don't know. That's just my thoughts, y'all. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Do you think this is gonna be one of the most epic movies we ever seen? You think they're gonna make up for what they did with the first movie? I don't know. You tell me what you think. Anyway, y'all, don't forget to like and subscribe. It's much appreciated, y'all. And I'll catch y'all ass out there in this universe. Peace. I'm sorry.
Long live the king.